Hi, Amy. I'm going to give it 1 second. Oh, hi, Mickey. Get my thoughts organized. They're upside down. Oh, Lord, I forgot something. Oh, well, we're going to roll with it. All right, so hello. Today we're going to talk about different ways to label the catalog. I've chosen a specific way that works for me, but other ways might work for you. I have a printer, so hi, Brittany. So I choose to print labels. So what I did is I got these from Walmart. They are Avery 18294. So they are like 60 to a page. So I use these for my fizzy bombs, and I also use these for my address labels because I can get more and you can still read them. So I need address labels. You just punch this little number into the Avery template thing, and then I just chose a blank one, and then I didn't choose color because that's a waste to me. Anyway, so I made address labels, and I also made these. It says, buy, reorder, host, join Jessica Carvalho on Facebook. And then it has my link, or what my link is to my website. So that out link and go ask your daddy.
I just want cookies.
We don't even have any cookies.
My answer and we did.
Oh, maybe they're in the cabinet. I don't know. Close the door. I swear to God, they don't ask me things for hours, and then they sense that I'm doing something. They're like, where is she? We need cookies now. Anyways, so this little blank spot on the back, I think, is the perfect spot to put your label. If you want it really known, you could also put it like in the front, like right here, maybe down here somewhere. But I put mine in the blank spot. This is a glossy catalog, so it is a little trickier. The last catalog were paper, so I used a self-inking stamp on them. Yeah. So this is my stamp. Pretty much when you press it down, it flips and then stamps on the paper. So, because it's glossy, you can't do that anymore, it'll smear. The solution is to get the Avery square labels. They're almost the size of like name badges. I didn't have time to do that to show you guys. So I just grabbed some name badges from Dollar Tree that were 25 for a dollar. But roughly this is the size you're going for. So you can get those blank squares or rectangles. Okay, yes, that's got to be it. So you can get the square rectangles. Yes, these are name tags. Yes, I don't care. All right, so this is what it looks like. I just smashed my stamp onto it. But you can get ones that are blank, and you can get ones that are smaller than this, of course. Amazon has a lot of them. Yeah, that's what I was going to do with my stamps. I was going to stamp things. I think I'm just going to use it right now on brochures and stuff, or I'm going to use square things. Also, if you happen to have the ones from the portal, which these can be pricier to use on your catalogs. If you happen to have these ones from the portal or the rectangle, I got my stamp from a place called simplystamps.com. They're actually based in Jacksonville, Florida, which is close to me. It's funny, I didn't know that when I ordered it, and it came like crazy fast. But Vistaprint, I think, has them. I've seen them on Groupon for cheap, and then I've also seen them on Etsy for cheap. It's called a self-inking stamp, so it flips, which is really cool because you don't have to buy ink pads. So if you have the stickers from the portal, you can use those. They have the round ones. They also have the rectangular ones. I prefer to print my own because they're cheaper. These I got with perks, or I prefer to get them with perks. Another option for the stamp is that you could stamp it on your catalog and then cover it with tape. So if you covered it with, say, packing tape, Scotch tape would be too small. I would cover it with like one strip of packing tape, and it would not smudge, it wouldn't smear, it would be ready to go. I love the glossy catalogs so much. It's seriously my favorite catalog ever. It's super cool. I love how it reads like a magazine. Oh yeah, no, this is way better. I am so lazy. All I have to do is seriously, when I'm labeling my catalogs, or before when I was labeling my catalogs, I can still do it now if I covered them, is seriously just go. Like, it's so freaking easy. That's it. It just prints it on there. So easy. There is a sweet toy outside my door. All right, so that is pretty much how to label the catalogs. Another good idea that I really, really like to do, because I like to make them more personal, is... My kid's talking outside the door. I believe my stamp was like $15 or $20. I had a coupon code, I think, or it was on sale or something. It wasn't very much. I think it was a medium-sized stamp. I'm pretty sure. So one of my favorite things to do with the catalog, which I haven't done this one yet, but it's to write notes in it. That makes it super, super personal. And you can get these little post-its from Walmart or from Dollar Tree. They're like an arrow, like they're like a pointer post-it. So if you didn't want to write in it, you could write, this is one of my favorites, top five favorites. Please ignore the squeak toy outside the door. I'm going to scold my child. He's trying to get my attention so I can look for points for him, apparently. So anyways, you can get the little like pointer post-its that are like long and skinny and put them on where is something you like. You can put like a great for bug bites on the stripper, DIY spa time for the foot stuff, which by the way, that hot, the Toes Before Bros hot towel wrap thing, so amazing. Yeah, you can do that. You can staple a business card. You can even glue dot a business card. They have glue dots at Walmart, and I believe I've also seen them at Dollar Tree. There's another thing you can do with samples if you wanted to. You can glue dot them to where they're supposed to be. So, like, if you have a hand cream, you can glue dot it to where the hand creams are or that particular one. So, yeah, you can staple it or you can glue dot it. I wouldn't use, like, actual glue, though. That sounds messy. But, yeah, that's it. There's a bunch of different ways that you can label your catalogs. When I first started, I couldn't afford any of the stickers or anything. So I hand wrote on every catalog. And our link was long back then. Our link was... http://18487/something else. It was really long. It's still on my card, the actual, like, long link. It was way harder than this. Way harder. So, that is the ways. I hope you like this video. And I hope everybody has a great night. Bye!